The Azure Database Migration Service for that. The Azure Database Migration Service really help you to migrate the actual databases here. So this is the service I already created. Let me go back to the service that I already created here. This is a service that I created, which is called Raj PO DMS Demo 2, which has, you know, multiple projects here that I already use those projects to do the migrations. But otherwise, once you create the service, if I go to this migration project here, there are two migration activities that are already running. One is running and the other one is failed. And if I go to run migration here, this is the database that we use for database migrations. We use backup and restore technology, where we get the full backup from your on-premises environment and we restore it. And then we also look for the subsequent log backup files that you provide to us. And we keep uploading those log backup files and apply those backups to the blob storage and restore them. So that's why, as you see here, there are a bunch of log files that are being already restored. And then this database is ready to do the migration cutover. So when you are ready to do the migration cutover, in the final step, what you do is you stop all the incoming traffic that is coming into the source, and you take a final log backup and provide that final log backup for the DMS. And DMS can upload that final log backup here. Once you see that that backup is already restored, then you simply call out a migration cutover. And once the migration cutover is done, then your target database will be become online. So that way you can really use your database migration service to minimize your downtime, because your downtime only starts during the cutover. The time it takes you to stop all the incoming traffic, plus the time it takes to take the final log backup, which is a brief log backup, and then the time it takes to restore that log backup through our DMS service, is the only time that you have a migration downtime, which you can cut down up to 15 minutes or even less, right? So I'm not going to call out the cutover because I already migrated my database for saving the time here. I just want to show that how this experience is going to look like to you using our tools. With that, assume that my database migration is already done. I'm going to pass it back to Gaurav to perform the application migration that way you can see that the whole application is being migrated.
Publicly accessible. What you do, you just navigate to appmigration.microsoft.com. And over here, you go ahead and provide the URL of your web application and press access. Now, what you get next is a detailed report about what your application, the set of technologies that your application is built on. And once you are done with that, you can go ahead and download the tool. And as you can see that we support .NET migration, we also support migration of your apps running Java and which are also hosted on Linux OS. So today we are going to focus completely on ASP.NET web application migration. The other way to start your migration journey is again using the same Azure Migrate experience. Once you are within Azure Migrate, you can start by assessing your web application. Now, assessing a web application again means that we run a host of readiness checks, and these readiness checks could be like the port that you're currently running on. What is the authentication mechanism? Are you using an IaaS API filter, to name a few? And once you pass all the assessment checks, that's where we ascertain that yes, your web application can successfully migrate to Azure App Services. Once you click on assess, you see we have an option to download the migration assessment tool. Now I have already downloaded the tool, and once you execute the tool, this is the experience that you start with. Now this tool automatically discovers the web application which are hosted on your local IIS web server. You select the web application that you want to assess, click next, and if you see behind the scene, this is running all the readiness checks that I spoke about. It's about TCP ports, protocols, location tags, to name a few. There are, in total, we run around 13 readiness checks. Once you have passed, your web application has passed all the readiness checks, you click next, And now what you do here is you go ahead and select the subscription that you want to use for this migration. You can either create a new resource group or use an existing resource group. You provide a name for your web application, like I have already provided the name. You can use whatever name you wish to as long as it is unique. And you can now choose either to create a new app service plan or you can choose an existing app service plan. And if you want to centralize the entire telemetry of your migration journey into Azure Migrate, you select the Azure Migrate project and you're good to go. Now, there's another interesting call out I want to make on this screen. If you see when we talk about databases, we are talking about how do you want to handle database connections? So you may want to skip the database setup, because if I go with the flow that Raj just showcased and I assume that my data is already migrated to Azure SQL, I can simply skip the database setup, and post migration, I can go ahead and change the connection string for my web application to point to the database which is migrated to Azure SQL. Or I can also set up hybrid connections. This will be a scenario where, for maybe regulatory reasons, I am unable to currently migrate my database to Azure, but I am going ahead and migrating my web application to Azure. And now my web application is going to use hybrid connections to connect seamlessly to my database on-prem. We'll go ahead and start the migration. Now, in the interest of time, I have already migrated a web application. And once your migration completes successfully, this is the experience that lights up for you. If I go to Azure App Services and if I see the web application over here, this is the experience that lights up once your application is migrated to Azure App Services. Now you can see there are host of features that you can configure for your web application right out of the portal here.